The following story has been brought to you by StoriesToInspire.org.
But I want to tell you a story that happened with a couple that I know in Israel. They don't want I should say their name, and you'll see why in a second. Many years ago, they had a little boy. And just an hour after the baby was born, the mother of the baby told me that two doctors and two nurses came into her room. And when two doctors and nurses come in an hour after the baby is born, something is wrong. Now we know that women have bina yaseira, they have a special perception. And she told me, I knew in a second there's something wrong with my baby. I didn't know what it was, but I knew there was something wrong. And the doctors told her, they said, we have never seen this in Israel before. Your baby doesn't know how to be bolea. The baby doesn't know how to swallow. As soon as the baby is born, they clear the throat, they clear the chest, and they give the baby to drink. But the baby, it was dribbling out of the mouth, it was coming down the sides. And no matter how much they tried to get the baby to swallow, the baby couldn't swallow. So they put him on intravenous, and they called every hospital in Israel to find out if there was ever a child that was born that way, that didn't know how to swallow. And she told me that what happened was, of course, the child couldn't have a bris. He was put in intensive care and he was hooked up to monitors and everything. And they called all over the world and they took x-rays and they wanted to see, is there a blockage in the throat or is it mental? Mental would be worse. A blockage, you could operate and take it away, but how are you going to teach a kid how to swallow? And they took x-rays and they saw there was no blockage. They would have to teach this child how to swallow. Now the child was 30 days old. He had to have pidyon haben. And the family came to the hospital and they saw the little baby on the monitors, on the feeding tubes. Everybody was crying. And they made the pidyon. The baby didn't even have a name yet because he didn't have his bris. And then the father, they did the pidyon, and then the father said, I want to give a bracha to Hashem. And everybody was wondering, what bracha is he going to give to Hashem? And he got up and he said this bracha, Baruch atah Hashem Elokeinu Melech Olam, Asher Yotzar es Adam b'chachma. And he started saying the whole bracha of Asher Yotzar. Uvor avoy nekovim nekovim chalulim chalulim. If something is closed, and the father was crying, and everybody was crying, how's this kid going to live? But eventually they were able to train him, and he was able to swallow. It's unbelievable. Eventually he had his bris, and I just want to tell you that this story happened more than 20 years ago, and this young man, I know his family very well. He didn't grow tall like the other children of his family. He's older than them, but he's shorter than them, but he is married and he's the father of a little girl. Baruch Hashem. But I want to tell you something. If any of you can get the Sefer of Rav Schwab on prayer, and you'll see the kavanot that he says that we should have by Asher Yotzar, do you know that the Vilna Gaon says, the only bracha that we say, Kisei Kivodecha, that's the highest place of Kedusha in the world, we say it in Asher Yotzar. It's almost embarrassing to talk about. We don't say it by Brit Milah, we don't say it by Shofar, Megillah, Matzah, Megillah, Chanukah, nothing. By going to the bathroom, we say, Golav Yadul Afnei Kisei Kivodecha. Why? And the Vilna Gaon writes, because everybody should know that even from the highest place of Kedusha, Hashem takes care of our bodies, and we have to be very grateful.
Enjoyed this story? Come again. Bring a friend. StoriesToInspire.org